Hi friends, welcome to our channel. So in this class we are going to discuss about the new chapter India after independence. Before we discussed about the revolt of 1857. So okay, it is a part of a very important independent war. And again here we are going to discuss India after independence. So after independence also we can face a very big and a great challenges. Now we are going to discuss. First of all, welcome to Lakshmi Sairam Study and Activities channel. In the last class, we discussed about verb forms. And again, let us go to the topic India after independence. Now, let us read the headlines. A new and divided nation. A new and divided nation means, like it is a forming, like it is form a new country. So, it is forming a new country and also dividing to another country. Like, we are divided, so the Pakistan divided from our country, like a new and divided nation. When India became independent in August 1947, okay, we got independence in August 1947, it faced a series of very great challenges. So, we faced a very great challenges. So, as a result of partition, 8 million refugees had come into the country from what was now Pakistan. So almost 8 million. So almost 8 billion people. So migrate to the country of Pakistan. So Pakistan is divided into our nation. So these people had to be found homes and jobs. So there is no homes and jobs. So at the time they are doing jobs and their homes is there in India. But after dividing into Pakistan, they had no homes and jobs. Now, it is also a very big challenge. Then there was a problem of princely states. Princely state means the state which has been ruling with kings, maharajas or nawabs. So, each of whom has been persuaded to join the new nation. Means almost 500 of them states has been ruling maharajas or nawabs. So at the time we have parliamentary system, but these 500 having democratic system. So we can now will change the democratic system to parliamentary system. So how can we change? That is also a very great big and great challenge. So each of whom had to be persuaded to join the new nation. The problems of the refugees and of the princely states. So there are two main problems: to invite the refugees again to India, and also been improved the parliamentary system in the princely states. In the longer term, the new nation had to be adopt a political system. So in the longer term, so by improving the nation, so we have to adopt a political system, a stiff and a very hard system, a political system. Means it has a good system that would best serve the hopes and expectations of its population. So that best serve the hopes and expectations of its population. So at that time there is a big population. So that political system has been improved, has been settled at this like a big population. Okay, here you are seeing Mahatma Gandhi's parade. He is just being immersed in Allahabad. So he has been called to a parade to have assembled in Allahabad, February 1948. Means, like in the January 30, Mahatma Gandhi has passed and died. So less than 6 months after independence. So after the 6 months of the independence, so it is a very bad situation of India. At the situation also, Mahatma Gandhi passed on 30 January 1948. So Nathuram Godse fight in the clot blood of Mahatma Gandhi died at that place only. At that evening, Eastern Nation head Jawaharlal Nehru conducted a meeting that has been declared Mahatma Gandhi died and after a meeting that has been invited. Friends and comrades, the light has gone off our lives and there is a darkness everywhere. So Jawaharlal Nehru said that is our lights has been. So Mahatma Gandhi is that time a father of nation. So so it has been not there means the people also will not digest it. So they have been very in the sad situation. Not only that, in the total country they have sad situation at the time. And again you are seeing here India's population in 1945. So India's population in 1947 was not large, almost 345 million. So almost 345 million means double now in the population. That is a double in the past population, because Pakistan also will part at the time in 1947 in India. So there is a big population. It was also divided. There were divisions between high castes and low castes. Okay, there were divisions between caste means a religion. Hindus are Muslims. There are divisions between these two castes. Between the majority Hindu community and Indians who practice other faiths. So in India, there were a mainly large population of Hindus. The citizens of this vast land spoke many different languages. But in India, there are speaking different languages in different places. Different kinds of dresses are also they are wearing, and different kinds of food they are eating, and practice different professions. Not only one foreman or peasants. Not only that, so many professions are practicing. How could they be made to live together in one nation? So this is a problem. Means how could they live together? So they are practicing different professions, eating different food. But how could they be in unity between them? That is a big challenge that at that time. Under to the problem of unity was added the problem of development was not there at that time, because at that time only we gained independence. So how to develop the country? And again the problem of unity, there is lack of unity at that time. There is we have two big challenges under at the independence. At independence, the vast majority of Indians lived in the villages. So at the time of independence, so many Indians has been lived in the villages. Farmers and peasants depended on the monsoon for their survival. So monsoon season means rainy season. So farmers has been dependent at the monsoon season, because at that time only rains will be fall, and the crops also will grow nicely. Okay, farmers. So did the non-farm sector for the rural economy. For if the crops failed, barbers, carpenters, weavers and other service groups would not get paid for the services either. If the crops failed, the farmers get losses, and the barbers, carpenters, weavers and other service will get not paid for the services either. So they can be not paid for them, because there is no money with them. So in the city, factory workers lived in crowded slums with little access to education or health care. Okay, at the cities also they live in the slums, factory workers. So there is no education or health care in the slums. There is a big problem. Clearly, the new nation had to lift its masses out of property by increasing the productivity of agriculture and by promoting new job creating industries. Clearly, we are observing so much difficulties, problems, but how to clear these problems for improving the agriculture? First of all, agriculture will improve in so many professions has been getting again back to the money. So and by promoting new job creating industries. So by keeping so many industries, jobs also for so many people, the jobs also will promote. Unity and development had to go hand in hand. So unity and development had to go hand in hand. So there is unity development. Together they will work and they will improve the unity and development. If the divisions between different sections of India were not healed, they could result in violent, costly conflicts. So with the lack of unity, they will revolt against, they will the violent situations will occur in India. So we can be at the time, they can be very careful. High caste fighting with low caste. So Hindus, Muslims, high caste and low caste, they are fighting each other. There is a big problem. At the same time, the fruits of economic development did not reach the broad masses of our population. It could refresh divisions. So the economical rate also are very important for the development of a country. So the economical rate will be developed. The fresh divisions will create. The fresh divisions will create and also some problem will clear. For example, between the rich and the poor, between cities and the countryside, between regions of India that were prosperous and regions that lagged behind. For example, Muslim and Hindus we told, and also between villages, countries, villages or cities, countries and cities, between regions of India there will a unity. Unity is a very very big weapon of development of India. Okay, this is our today's class. Today's class we discussed about the problems of India. At the time, a very big, not a big problems, sorry, not a problems, a big challenges. So you can say as a big challenges. So challenges will, a very, very big challenges will occur at the times. In this class, we discuss about challenges. And again, tomorrow's class, we discuss about how the challenges has been back up. So how the challenges was cleared. How are the solutions can be happens of the problems. We can discuss in the tomorrow's class. So I think this class is very understandable for you. And also today's class is completed. Friends, if you like this video, press like button and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you. Thanks for watching.